You've probably heard about melatonin as being a hormone that helps control our sleep and wake cycle. But melatonin isn't just something that those suffering from jet lag may be focused on. New research is now showing that this humble hormone has an important role to play in a woman's fertility. In today's video, I'll tell you what you need to know about melatonin and fertility and the things that you can do to keep your melatonin levels healthy and improve your chances of conceiving. Stay tuned. Melatonin has been dubbed the sleep hormone because it helps us doze off to sleep and get the rest our body needs. It's made in the brain in a small pea-sized gland called the pineal gland. Melatonin plays a vital part in our 24-hour circadian rhythm, which helps our body know when it's time to sleep and wake up. Melatonin levels are normally highest at night and begin to rise when the sun sets. The levels fall again in the morning when the sun comes up. Now, this normal cycle is all well and good if we lived in our natural environment, but our modern lives can throw this delicate balance out. Many people aren't outdoors during the day to get enough sun, but worse still, we expose ourselves to too much light at nighttime, both from indoor lights and also from the phones and laptops our eyes may be glued to before bed. But melatonin has more roles to play than just regulating our sleep-wake cycle. This hormone can influence a wide variety of cellular processes that affect cancer risk, heart disease, and yes, even fertility. A recent review of studies looking at melatonin and female reproduction came to the striking conclusion that healthy melatonin levels are necessary for optimal fertility. You see, melatonin plays its part by protecting our eggs from free radical damage. What are free radicals, I hear you ask? Well, they're molecules that are highly reactive with other cellular structures because they contain unpaired electrons. These unpaired electrons can cause damage to parts of cells such as proteins, DNA, and cell membranes by stealing their electrons through a process called oxidation. So basically, free radicals are bad guys that harm our eggs. Melatonin is like a little policeman finding the bad guys and preventing them from doing harm. Technically, it acts as an antioxidant in the ovaries, removing free radicals and preventing cellular damage, especially during ovulation, when our eggs are the most vulnerable. The end result? Well, optimal amounts of melatonin create healthier and more fertile eggs. So this means that shift workers could be even at greater risk from fertility problems. The disrupted sleep cycle and too much exposure to nighttime lights disrupt the circadian rhythm, leading to menstrual cycle irregularities, which can then impact on your fertility. The research into melatonin and fertility goes even deeper, with new research suggesting that melatonin plays a crucial role in fetal development as well. Low levels of melatonin production during pregnancy can harm your baby, potentially triggering problems with his biological clock and contributing to health issues down the line. But the great news about melatonin comes from some exciting new research. It seems that women with poor egg quality having IVF treatments who are treated with melatonin supplements are more likely to fall pregnant. Research has found that women taking melatonin before their IVF cycle had 50% of their eggs successfully fertilized, compared to less than 23% of the eggs in the control group. Following embryo transfer, 19% of women taking the melatonin supplements became pregnant, compared to just over 10% of the women who didn't take it. And supporting these findings, a systematic review from 2014 found that melatonin supplementation during IVF increased the pregnancy rate by 21%. So, Let's get down to the practical bits and discuss what you can do to keep your melatonin levels in balance. The key message is that the more light that you're exposed to at night, when your body is trying to wind down and get you to sleep, the more melatonin production is impaired. That's bad news for your fertility. What you're striving for is a stable, light-dark environment. For a start, you want to aim for at least 8 hours of darkness at night. Darkness is needed for a regular biological clock and to produce a good dose of melatonin. Sleep is great, but it's the darkness that's needed for the brain to produce that melatonin. Next, you want a fairly regular schedule so that your light-dark cycle is regular from one day to the next. At night, minimize light close to bedtime. This means turning off the TV and taking your eyes off your phone, tablet, and laptop. Many of these devices now have automatic nighttime blue light dimming, so make use of this function. It's the shorter wavelengths in blue light that is what causes the body to produce less melatonin because the body is more sensitive to this type of light. And fourthly, keep your bedroom as dark as possible and with no outside light coming in through the windows. Finally, I'd also like to chat a bit about supplements. It appears that taking low doses of melatonin is safe for a healthy person if taken for a short period of no more than 3 months. Melatonin is commonly taken at night before bed for a variety of sleep disorders and also jet lag. If you're thinking of taking melatonin to boost your fertility, you should certainly discuss the issue with your doctor or fertility specialist first though. Now, let me ask you, what are you going to do to optimize your melatonin levels? Let me know in the chat box below. Okie dokie, so I've given you a lot of information today, so let's summarize. Firstly, melatonin is called our sleep hormone for good reason, as high levels at nighttime help us to fall off to sleep. But melatonin does a lot more than helping us sleep, with new research finding it vital for healthy eggs and fetal development. Number three, in controlled trials, women on IVF who are given melatonin supplements had a much higher chance of successful fertilization and implantation. And finally, if you want to keep your melatonin levels optimal, then you need to start practicing good bedtime routines tonight and every night right up until your little one arrives, when you can expect to get very little sleep at all. Now, I'm sure that you'll have loads of questions, so feel free to post them in the comments below. And remember, melatonin alone isn't going to help you to conceive. You need a nutritious diet. So I'd love you to download my free fertility meal plan. Just go to melaniemcgrice.com/fertility. You can find the link in the chat box below. I look forward to catching up with you next week on Nourish, both from indoor lights and also from phones and laptops. And our eyes may, The levels fall again. Optimal amounts. Now let me, it's disappeared again. I wonder what's causing that.
Strange.
Hmm.